What I want to do in this video is dig a little bit deeper in this marginal product revenue curve and really make sure we understand what it's telling us, that it really is the marginal benefit curve for this firm. And in the video we constructed it, this firm is a car wash. And also how we can use this to think about what's a rational number of people for this firm to hire. And just as a reminder, this horizontal axis here, this is a quantity of labor per hour. So this is people per hour that are working at the firm, people per hour. And the vertical axis here, the marginal product revenue, that you could view as the marginal dollars or the incremental dollars that you're getting per person per hour. Per person, person, per hour, per hour. And to just verify that it's telling us the same thing visually that this table told us right up here, we can think about what is the marginal, how much incremental revenue do we get from hiring that first person? So what we could do is we can multiply the quantity of people, which is 1, times the average increment, the average marginal product revenue that we get from one person, or I should say the average we get going from 0 to one person. And the average is 25. The average is 25. And the reason why I said it that way is you can imagine a reality where getting a tenth of a person, you get a value higher than 25. And you might say, how do I get a tenth of a person? Well, what if one person shows up every 10 days? And then you get a little less benefit as you get closer and closer to a whole person per hour. But on average, as we go from 0 to one person, we are getting $25 of value, or $25 of marginal revenue per person per hour. And so if you wanted to figure out what's the total marginal revenue that we got from this person right over here, the total incremental revenue that this is allowing us to get, well, it's the one person times the average marginal product revenue, which is 25. So that would give us the area of this rectangle right over there, which would be $25. Now, and you would really have to do a little bit of calculus to fully appreciate it, but I think you can look at it geometrically, that that also happens to be, given that this is a line, that our curve, our marginal product revenue is a line right over here, that the area under this rectangle is going to be the same thing as the area under the orange curve. The orange curve for between 0 and 1/2 is above this rectangle, and between 1/2 and 1, it is below the rectangle. And the area above is the same as the area below. So $25 is also the area under this curve. And that's essentially how much benefit the firm is getting from hiring, from going from 0 to one person. They're getting $25 of benefit. Now, how much benefit do they get going from 1 to 2 people? Well, going from 1 to 2, our change in quantity of people per hour is 1. And then our average marginal product revenue going from 1 to 2 people is $20. So it is $20. And so the area is 1 times 20. And that's also going to be the same as the area under the curve. So the area under the curve right over there is going to be 20. Likewise, the area under the curve, if we wanted to say what's the marginal product revenue we get going from 2 to 3 people? Well, the average height here, we'd essentially just say, well, what is the area between 2 and 3? And we can figure out that area by saying, well, the average height is 15, multiply 15. So this height, the average height is 15, multiply 15 times 1. You get $15, $15 of benefit. Between 3 and 4, the average height is 10. The average height is 10, so you get 10 times 1, you get $10 of benefit, would be the area under the curve right over here. $10 of benefit, and then the area under the curve there, by the same argument, is $5, is $5 of benefit. Now, we've given this, this is just telling us the revenue we're getting, but it's really not telling us what is the optimal or the rational number of employees to hire. To do that, we have to think about the cost per employee, the marginal cost that we are actually incurring. And I mentioned earlier that this is a competitive firm. And when I mentioned it before, I talked about it being competitive in terms of the car wash market. So it was a competitive supplier. But let's assume that it is also a competitive buyer in the labor market. So these are two different markets, and I want to clarify. In the car wash market, we are a competitive supplier, or I guess we could say we are a seller of car washes. In the labor market, in the labor market, our firm is a competitive buyer. Now, I'll do a little bit of an aside here, because when we talk about suppliers, there's the competitive suppliers, where there's many undifferentiated people who are supplying some type of good or service. And the opposite of that was a monopoly. So non-competitive. As a seller, we call that a monopoly. If we had a non-competitive buyer, so if you had many sellers but only one big buyer that could have a lot of market influence, and we haven't done a deep analysis of that yet, that word, just so you know it, and it doesn't, you know, you're not taken by surprise if someone says it, just it means monopsony, or the word is monopsony. Monopsony. Not relevant to this video. We are the opposite of a monopsony in the labor market. We're assuming that we are a competitive buyer. There are many, 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 many buyers here. So we essentially just have to take the market wages. And we are also the opposite of a monopoly in the car wash market. We're assuming that we are one of many competitive sellers. Monopoly means only one seller. Monopsony means one powerful buyer. But the whole reason why I'm saying that we are competitive in the labor market is I'm assuming that we're just going to have to take the market wages. So the market wage for the type of labor we're hiring, so the market wage, and we're just going to have to take that, the market wage is going to be, let's just say it is $10 per hour. $10 per hour. And given that, what is a rational number of people to hire? Well, that first person we hire, we're getting $25 of benefit. The marginal cost of them, and we can actually draw a marginal cost curve. The marginal cost curve will just be flat right here at $25. It'll be flat here at $10. That's how much it costs us. If we hire one person, it costs us, the area would be $10. If we hire two people, the area would be between 0 and 2 and under the curve, which would be 20. Or you could say the increment from going from 1 to 2 people is another $10. From going to 2 to 3 people, this area right over here is another $10. If you go from 3 to 4 people, this area under here is another $10 under this green curve. So does it make sense to hire that first person? Sure, you're going to get $25 in revenue, and you're going to have $10 in wages, so you're going to have $15 of benefit. So you definitely want to hire one person. Does it make sense to hire that second person? Well, the marginal product revenue is going to be $20 from that second person. Your marginal cost from that second person is $10. So you're going to make $10 on that second person. So you should hire that second person. The third person, you're going to make $15 off them. They're going to cost you $10. So you're going to, and this is all on a per hour basis, you're going to make $5. So you should hire that. The fourth person, well, now it's interesting. The fourth person, you're going to make $10 in total off of the fourth person, but you're also going to have to pay $10 for that fourth person. So it doesn't make sense for you to hire another total fourth person. Now, if you could, it could make sense for you to hire another half person, maybe someone who shows up every other day, if this still holds, or maybe someone who shows up for half an hour, or maybe someone who is doing this job and also operating the cash register, and they're kind of going in between. Because for a half person, it does make sense. A half person is going to cost $5, and their marginal benefit is going to be the area under the curve between this point and this point. And so the profit from that person, the net benefit we're going to get is going to be this area right over here. So it would be rational to get them. But what you're seeing is it makes sense to keep increasing the quantity demanded. It makes sense to keep hiring more and more people until the marginal benefit, or another way of saying the marginal product revenue curve, is equal to the marginal cost curve. After that point, the person's costs are higher than their benefits, and you wouldn't want to hire them.